Hello friends, this is Grawl. Welcome to my new and improved updated 9.2.5 UI video. This is sort of an in-betweener. I've been upgrading and changing around my UI a little bit in preparation for the new expansion, so the finalized version probably won't be done until Dragonlands or Dragonflight or whatever's out. However, I've been getting a lot of requests and people looking to check out my new UI and try and use it for themselves, so I wanted to do a video breakdown. I'll have all the links in the description for various profiles and stuff, and if you're looking for help or you can't figure stuff out, the yumytv Discord is also a great place to come ask questions or just to hang out and do some keys. So before I get started on breaking down individual add-ons, I want to talk about just why I changed it in the first place, since that's a really, really big question. I feel like everyone's worried that, like, all of a sudden the add-ons they're using are a virus or something, but there's three main reasons. The first one is to improve visibility. Not just for me, but for the stream as well. I felt like the other UI that I had was a bit convoluted, and it had a little bit too much on the screen. And also, if you weren't super familiar with the class or watching my screen, it would be hard to understand what exactly was going on. And I thought just switching to a more simplified UI would be easier to understand for people. And also, it may improve my own visibility as well. Secondly, I understand that a lot of people do discover and get into M+ through my stuff, and a lot of people like to replicate my UI and they tend to, you know, use my Weakauras or whatever, and I wanted to make something that was easier to replicate, something that you don't have to download a bunch of add-ons. You definitely will still have to download some add-ons, but hopefully it'll be easier than having to install LVUI and having to install Voodoo and all this other stuff. Hopefully it should be just download a few add-ons that are necessary and plug and play. And lastly, I hope that it'll also increase the performance of my game as well. The way I see it is the fewer add-ons I use and the fewer Weakauras that I use, the better my game should run. So yeah, that's the main reasons. Also, you know, it's kind of fun just to switch up your UI and try new stuff out. So that being said, let's get into the different elements of my UI. I will leave timestamps as well as everything else, links and stuff in the description. Like I said, I'll go a little bit basic just to start. Just, you know, I don't know exactly what levels everyone's at with their add-ons and UI stuff, but the first thing I want to talk about is Weakauras. Weakauras is essentially a mandatory add-on that's used for UI customization, and a lot of the pop-ups and various information that you see on my screen comes from Weakauras. So you see, for instance, here I have a Weakaura that helps me track my flash concentration stacks. I also have a Weakaura here that tracks my blood decay's runic power. You can see a Weakaura here that pops up that shows something is going on me. Weakaura is here in the middle that track the buffs that I have and my mana. And all this stuff I have available on my Weakauras page. Not all of it is always uploaded right away. You know, sometimes I'm trying them or testing them out, so you may not find everything, but for the most part, what I'm using, you'll find on there. And one thing to note is that not everything on the screen is Weakauras, and I'll go into some of the other stuff that isn't, but Weakauras is definitely a mandatory add-on, and I'll have a link to all my Weakauras that I use on stream. Secondly, the sort of like middle block with all my skills. Everyone always asks like to get this, so these are just literally three skill bars that I use from Bartender. Unfortunately, the two bar add-ons that I looked at, Bartender and Dominoes, don't seem to have a way to export profiles. However, it's very, very, very simple. Essentially, all I did was put three bars in the middle of my screen, and depending on what class you play, what skills you want to track, you can maybe only put two or maybe put more. And then also I have four bars here in the very bottom that are sort of like faded out just to help visibility a little bit. And those are where I set all my keybinds. So you'll see in the middle, I only have cooldowns that I'm trying to track and no keybinds or spells with, you know, no cooldown. And then all the stuff is bound down here. And this is where I change my keybinds and whatnot. Now, the reason that it may look different from your guys' keybinds or bar add-ons is because I use an add-on called Masque or Masque UI, and it essentially just reskins the bars and makes the skill icons look a little bit different. It gives them that nice, I think it zooms in a little bit, and then it gives them that nice black border just to make them look a little bit more defined. And that's an add-on that I believe the skin I use is called Clean UI Black or thin black or something like that, and I believe I'll have links to that stuff as well. But I would also recommend, if you download Masque, that you check out the different skins, and you know, you may find another one that you like better than this one. But so yeah, I'm using Bartender for my bars in the middle. You can use literally anything, dominoes or LVY bars if you really want to, but I happen to use Bartender, and Masque is the add-on that makes them look the way they do. So for my party frames, I've actually switched to base in-game party frames, and part of the reason is because I wanted to try the new party frames when Dragonflight comes out, just to see how the new sort of like base UI works. And so I want to try getting away without using a party frame add-on. So one, there's two different things I'm using that sort of help that out. The first one is called Big Debuffs. Big Debuffs allows you to see more buffs and debuffs on your frames. It also highlights some of the other important ones and makes them a little bit bigger. And so if you're wondering why the icons on your guys' frames might look a little different from mine, even though we're both using default, I'm using Big Debuffs. And for Big Debuffs, I literally just used it right out of the box. I haven't done any customizing with it. I may do that in the future, but it's not something that I've done a whole lot of right now. The other add-on that I'm using is OmniCD. OmniCD is all these icons on the left that tracks my party's cooldowns. You can see mostly defensive cooldowns and sometimes offensive ones, especially for Priest needing to PI. If you're not playing Priest, it's probably not super important that you see offensive cooldowns, but it is nice to see. And I'll have my OmniCD profile linked in the description of the vid as well. Next, I want to talk about Bigwigs. I would say probably mandatory to have a boss mods add-on. If you look in the top here where it says casting deadly thrust, and on boss fights, it'll give you little icons or bars on the bottom left that'll show you like when upcoming skills are going to happen. That is it's an add-on called Bigwigs. You can also use DBM, Deadly Boss Mods. Both of them are the same. I would say Bigwigs is a little quieter, a little lower key, and Deadly Boss Mods is a little more noisy. So depending on how loud, I guess, you want your alerts and how in your face you want them, do you like the air horns and stuff that's yelling at you, or do you want something a little bit more low key? So I use Bigwigs. And I would also recommend using Bigwigs to sort of customize sounds on different spells. If there's ever a spell that you feel like you don't recognize or you need to react to right away, like for instance, Loyal Beasts is a really important spell that I try to interrupt on these Houndsmasters. I have that a special sound, and you can use Bigwigs and DBM for that. So in the bottom right, I'm using Details. Details is a very common damage meter add-on. Not much to say about it. Tracks lots of things. I will have a link to my Details profile in the video description as well. That's one that's very, very common. For my nameplates, I'm using KUI nameplates. This is an add-on that, honestly, I've just used it for a long time. I would say most people probably use Plater. I think Plater has a little bit more customization, but for the most part, KUI has done everything I wanted it to do. Maybe there's a chance in the next expansion that I end up switching to Plater, but yeah, I use KUI nameplates. I'll have that profile in the description. I believe there's like a weird way you have to import those. I think you have to do like /KNP import in-game to import it. It doesn't have like a normal button or whatever that most other add-ons have. On the right side of my screen, my party frame add-on is Mythic Plus Timer, all one word. This is just, again, a add-on that I've used. It just simplifies the in-game timer a little bit, makes it more visible, at least to me. It also displays exact count of each mob, as well as the percentage count of how much are the mobs that you're in combat with, so you can kind of get an idea of like what your count is going to be after the pull that you're doing. There's tons of other solutions for this. Again, I would not necessarily just copy what I use. Definitely shop around and find one that you think you like the way it looks, but that's what I use. So now that I got rid of my LVY and my other add-ons, I did need an add-on for target frames and for focus frames. I don't really like the way the base UI displays target. Maybe in Dragonlands I'll switch it over and I'll try the base one again, but for now I'm using an add-on called Shadowed Unit Frames. This is my target frame right here on the right, as well as my focus frame, which is above my party frames, if I ever focus anything here. And I have my profile for that in the description as well, if you just want to copy paste that. But it's pretty easy, pretty simple. I just make sure I can see target of target and debuffs and stuff like that. And lastly, an add-on, if you look in the bottom right, you can see my tooltip looks a little bit different from the base. I use an add-on called Tiny Tooltip, and I've customized it a little bit just to kind of move it off to the side, make it a little bit simpler, as well as, you know, I just think it looks nice, better than the base WoW tooltips. It also disables during combat, I think. It should be, yeah. So now that I'm in combat, the tooltips won't be popping up and going all over the place. So that basically covers everything. You know, there's a handful of add-ons, and you definitely sort of want like a nameplate add-on. You're going to want Weakauras. You're going to want boss mods. But for the most part, you know, some of the add-ons, like for instance, the Mythic Plus timer is just customization and changing the way stuff looks. Let me actually go in game right now, and I'll show you guys a couple other add-ons that I use that people ask about a lot that I find very useful. The first one is called Opie. It is O-P-I-E, and this is allows you to bind multiple things or spells or whatever on a radial menu. So for example, these, I have all of the sort of like buffs that I use in dungeons on this menu, whether I need to resummon my steward, use an invis pot, reapply my oil or my augment rune, because with this setup, it can be a little annoying to have like buttons for all those or to open your bags. And so I just kind of have one button for all those. I have another button for sort of my out of combat stuff, like my wormhole and hearthstone. And if I need to do a repair mount or I need to turn everyone into corgis, you know, any of those is on this menu. This is a very helpful add-on as well. I'd highly recommend it. I wouldn't recommend using this add-on in combat, like putting actual skills that you're using in a pull on it, but it is nice for just, you know, like dungeon portals or maybe like potions, those sorts of things. The other add-on that I'm going to show is called Friend Groups. It actually does two things. I think it class colors people based off of their what character they're on. And it also allows you to group people in your friends list. Like, for example, I have my like main M plus friend team in the very top of my friends list. And then sort of like the other people that I play with. And then just like some of my other friends from other games down below that. And this is actually pretty helpful once you start building up an M plus network and you have, you know, 200 whatever people on your friends list. It can be a little annoying to scroll through everything. And one thing that I found very useful, it's an add-on called Click right here. And basically the way Click works is it sets up all your mouse over macros for you. So once you install Click, it adds a little button here on your spellbook. And then all you need to do is literally mouse over the spell. It'll say you're in binding mode. And you can just literally press your button. It will bind the spell to that hotkey. And then this way you don't have to use the in-game interface for setting up mouse over macros and stuff. You can do that if you want to, but this works with everything. It works with mouse buttons, it works with buttons, it works with modifier plus buttons. It's very, very helpful. It seems very lightweight, and it's pretty chill to use. I definitely recommend this add-on if you're not using a party frame add-on that has those. And the last add-on that I want to mention, just because it's so freaking helpful that no one ever talks about this, it's actually called right-click modifier. And one thing that happens, especially if you're a healer or someone who like needs to change their target a lot of the time, is let's say you you need to run a certain way. So you right-click and you spin your camera and you start running. But the problem is if you have someone moused over when you right-click, it'll target that person. So let's say you have a boss targeted, you know, you're fighting this boss, then you go like this to turn your camera, then you come back around, then you try and push Shadow Word Pain, but well, you're targeting your teammate or whoever you right clicked. And as far as I know, there's no way to change the way right click works in game. However, you can use right click modifier, which basically it gives you the option to disable right click targeting. I don't know if you can hear my mouse, but I literally cannot right click anybody. You can make it so it works in combat or out of combat. It may be a little strange if you play a class that you want to like auto attack often or whatever, but for healers especially, I think this add-on is like a freaking lifesaver. I remember when I was a noob and I didn't know about it, I struggled so much with even just like in raid, like constantly having to retarget the boss or whatever. I actually developed this really bad habit of pressing tab all the time just to retarget the boss because I would constantly just right click on my allies while I was moving my camera around. So yeah, that's another very helpful add-on that I would recommend. And for the most part, that's it. That is my entire UI. You know, just get some bars in the middle of your screen, spruce everything up with some Weakauras, you can spruce up your party frames a little bit with big debuffs and Omni CD, and yeah, shadow unit frames, and you're good to go. If you guys have any questions, feel free to leave them in the description of the video, or not in the description, in the comments of the video, and I'll try and go over and answer stuff if you guys are having trouble figuring it out. But for the most part, you should, you know, if there's anything else that I didn't mention in this video and you're like, hey, how do you do that, it's almost definitely a Weakaura. You know, for example, the stat numbers in the top left of my screen. Oh yeah, this is one thing, very small, the shadowed unit frames. I haven't set this up yet, but I actually don't have a personal party bar, if that makes sense. So I kind of just like have this in the top left. I hide it with my my GG banner right here. And yeah, normally people don't see that. I'm not sure exactly how I'm gonna do it. It's mainly just for solo content, for like clicking on yourself or doing whatever. But yeah, kind of a still a work in progress a little bit, but that's why that's there. If you wanted to move that and put it like, I don't know, maybe like under your bars or something, some weird spot, I don't know. But yeah, that wraps up everything. Any questions, leave them in the comments. Appreciate you guys. I hope the vid was helpful. Good luck and happy keying, friends.